Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. In this first episode we will paint the beautiful model of the Kingsman from Kingdom Death Monster board game. In this first video we will paint the true metallic armor of the model. Our first thing to do of course is priming. I recommend to use zenithal priming for almost all of your miniatures. This technique gives the most natural look of the shadows as the human eye is used to it. This is because the sun is shining on the sky, so the objects which surround us usually brighter on their top and darker on their bottom. To achieve this, we will use three different colors to prime the mini. Our first color will be black primer from Vallejo Acrylics. I like to prime my miniatures with an airbrush as it gives me more control than a spray, but if you don't have an airbrush, you can achieve the very same effect with primer sprays as well. Our next color is Stonewall Grey from Vallejo Game Color. I spray this from a 45 degree angle. This will leave the recesses black, while the rest of the mini will be grey. Finally, we spray white primer from the top of the model. As a result, the top parts of the model will be the brightest. Now that the model is primed, we can start the actual painting. Before start, let's study this picture. The real challenge in painting metals is that they are very reflective. They have their own highlights, but at the same time, they are reflecting the surrounding as well. I marked the parts with brownish arrows where the armor reflects the ground. Now, with blue arrows, I pointed the areas where the armor reflects the blue sky. To achieve this effect, we will mix metal paints with other colors. First, we use a mix of Citadel Lead Belcher, Vallejo Air Color Armor Brown and a bit of black to paint the areas with ground reflection. We will use pure lead belcher to the parts where we want the transition zones, like the top of the shoulder pad. For the parts which reflects the sky, we will use a mix of game color silver and air color steel blue, darkened with a bit of black. Apply the mix to the parts which are facing towards the sky. For final highlights, we use pure silver. Put this on the edges of the armor and in the center of your highlights. Thank you. When you paint highlights, try to follow the shape of the object. For example, the round shoulder pad should have a round highlight. To smoothen the transition, I used highly diluted silver and glazed it to the edges of the highlight. The brush strokes are very important for glazing, as you push the pigments with your brush to the right direction. We will talk more about glazing in a later chapter. Now that our final highlights are done, we finish the steel armor. Thank you for watching, I hope you liked the video. If you would like to get more tutorials, don't forget to subscribe. You can follow me on Facebook and Instagram as well to see work in progress and other behind the scenes photos. You can find this link down below. Feel free to comment or contact me if you have questions. Happy painting!